Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Makar Kodash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone that rule well. Peace, salutations, and blessings to the hopeful elect pushing his truth in sincerity throughout the four corners of the globe, in the sincere hopes of being delivered in these last days, all right? And inspiration for this video is drawn from this article that you see here on the screen, taken from World Council for Health, and is entitled The Orwellian Implications of MCRO-CHIPing Humans, all right? And, you know, for obvious reasons, I'm going to, censor, if you will, you know, particular wording in the hopes of not, you know, upsetting the algorithm of YouTube, all right? Because as we know, our videos, you know, here at Great Millstone are constantly under attack from, you know, YouTube for bringing out, you know, this word, all right, for bringing out the correct understanding of the Holy Scriptures, all right, which is another indication that we absolutely do have the truth, all right, because no other group out there gets strikes and, you know, if you will, disciplinaries like how Great Millstone get them, all right, because we're bringing out the truth and they don't want the truth, all right, to get out there. And that's why, you know, they deal with us in that way, all right? And again, you know, that's another indication as to who hosts, you know, the true divine words of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai, all right? So, you know, back to this article. It says here, most people are not aware of the number of people currently already tagged with an electronic identification system. It is widely used in the military, police forces, and on the homeless, refugees, and others. And, you know, that's another thing, you know, we've been telling you, you know, for a very long time, you know, beginning with Elder Apostle Tahar on down, is that there's many people in the world already that have, you know, the MOTB, okay, that have the, you know, the Revelations 13 and verse 16, all right, there's many people that have, you know, the CHIP embedded already in their body, all right, many people. Now, when you consider Sweden, cash is pretty much, you know, obsolete over there in Sweden. They don't deal with cash. There's places you can go, all right? Well, the majority of places you go in Sweden, they do not accept physical, tangible cash. Everything is digital, all right? So cash is pretty much, you know, been made obsolete over there in Sweden. And you have many people, thousands of people, that actually have, you know, the CHIP embedded in their bodies, all right? And that's, you know, right now, you know, as I speak, you have people using that technology over there in Sweden, and it's part of their everyday life. So when you have, you know, these camps out there going on like, you know, this is not a reality, or going on like, you know, this is something that is of the movies, all right, you really, you know, don't really understand, you know, what's truly going on upon the face of the earth, all right? And that's why the scriptures talk about, you know, stumbling blocks, because that's basically what you guys are. You know, you are stumbling blocks unto the undesirables of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai's nation, all right? Because the Lord has an elect, but the Lord also has, you know, of the Israelites, you know, those men and women that are not going to make it and that have not been bestowed, you know, with the gift of faith. All right, and it's as simple as that. So the Lord has set up stumbling blocks, all right, to keep the undesirables, you know, from getting and understanding this truth. Okay, now it says the healthcare industry is looking to the RFI to the D, not only to manage its supply chain, but also to prevent infants from being switched in hospital nurseries, to track Alzheimer's sufferers and to link patients to their medical records. Now, that's the point of sale. You know, as we always go into, there's a point of sale, you know, for this MOTB. All right. They're going to point out, you know, the benefits. They're going to point out, you know, how it can make your life easier. They're going to point out how it can make you stronger. They're going to point out, you know, how it can give you back, you know, the ability to see, you know, the ability to walk again, the ability to do all these things that, you know, you might have lost, or, you know, you might have some particular ailment that it can aid in helping you, you know, nursing yourself back to health. There's all kinds of different point of sale that they have when it comes to this MOTB technology. All right. It's very vast. Okay, which shows you that the spirit, you know, of Yahweh Bar Shem Yahweh Shai has, you know, bestowed upon Esau Edom the ability, you know, to advance in this technology, all right? And that's why, you know, the scriptures talk about, you know, in Ezekiel regarding them being wiser than Daniel, all right? Because the Lord has given them the ability to tap in to particular things that are going to woe the people in these last days, all right, these false miracles, okay, but those powers, those abilities are not comparable to the powers of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai and the true miracles and power, you know, that can be manifested through the right hand side, all right. It says global organizations like the UN and the WEF have developed strategies for a general identification of all humans, pointing at the multiple advantages of such a program. The European Union had begun to look at the medical, legal, and ethical aspects of the technology as early as 2005, which goes way, way before that, all right, because you actually had the guy who actually, you know, he created, or if you were invented, the RFI to the D, CHIP. And he said how, you know, he regretted, you know, creating the technology because, you know, he came to the conclusion that it was written of in the book of Revelations 13 and 16. All right. And that was way before 2005. I forget precisely when it was, but I know for sure it was way before 2005. So this agenda has been known, you know, for many, many, many years. All right. And even our, you know, apostles and elders talk about how, you know, this information was around from the 70s. Okay. But through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bar Shem Yahweh Shai, you know, the spirit has, you know, jumped upon our apostles and elders to delve deep, you know, into this prophecy and to, you know, bring it to life. All right. And that's why, you know, the scriptures say, you know, let's get it right quick in Amos 3 and 7. Let's get this right quick. This is Amos chapter 3 and 7. It says, surely the Lord power will do nothing, but he revealeth his secret unto his servants, the prophets. All right. Surely the Lord power will do nothing, but he revealeth his secret unto his servants, the prophets, man. All right. And that's exactly what Yahweh Bar Shem Yahweh Shai has done in these last days. He's revealed his secrets unto his servants, you know, the prophets. All right. The ones that host, you know, his pure words. Okay. And that's why, you know, when you survey, you know, Great Millstone and the, you know, the apostles and elders on down, you can blatantly see, you know, that the spirit of Yahweh Bar Shem Yahweh Shai dwells with this congregation, because this information and the warnings, you know, are coming out, you know, nonstop. All right. And that's the spirit that we're supposed to be in, is constantly warning the people about the coming changes, the new world order system that's about to be rolled out upon this earth, all right? And if you're not warning the people of these things, all right, then you are not a prophet, all right? You are not, you know, of Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, because that's what a true prophet, you know, a true man of the Lord should be doing, you know, in these last days, is warning the people of the coming changes, all right, and the prophecies of Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai that's contained within the book, all right? And let me get, what's that, Joel 2, you know, regarding blowing the trumpet, all right, because it's very, very important. Now, this is Joel chapter 2 and verse 1, and it says, "Blow ye the trumpet in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord cometh, for it is nigh at hand." All right? So the scriptures command us to sound an alarm, okay? Now, when you consider an alarm, and we always make this analogy, when you consider an alarm is very annoying. An alarm is repetitive, okay? An alarm makes the same exact sound over and over again, okay? And that's the exact role, you know, that we're to play in the spirit, all right? It's sounding the alarm. It's giving you the same message over and over again, warning you of the ramifications of taking the MOTB, warning you of the ramifications, you know, the consequences of not repenting unto Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, and seeking for repentance, you know, forgiveness for your transgressions. Okay, we're constantly warning you of these things, and we will be warning you of these things until the point where we're not able to do it anymore, when the famine of the word is established upon the earth. Okay, so that's our job, that's our duty. Okay, in Romans 12, it talks about us being a living sacrifice unto Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai. Okay, and that's our reasonable service. All right, this is what we were set up to do, is to warn the people. Okay? Now, the scriptures also make mention of the uncertain sound. Let me see if I can find that. I believe it might be in Corinthians somewhere. Let's see if it pops up. Lord willing, it does. All right, beautiful. Kala Yaba Shimi Al Shai. So this is 1 Corinthians chapter 14 and verse 8. And it says here, "For if the trumpet give an uncertain sound, who shall prepare himself to the battle?" All right, so you can't give an uncertain sound, all right? When it said in Joel 2 that we're to blow the trumpet in Zion, that's talking about blowing it in the correct fashion, all right? Warning the people. We're blowing the trumpet of war, okay? We're blowing the trumpet of warning you people, all right, you Israelites, you Negroes, Hispanics, and Native American Indians, of the coming danger that our enemy is plotting against you, okay? So you have these other congregations, you know, these other camps out there, they're blowing an uncertain sound, all right? They're not blowing the trumpet correctly. They're not blowing a trumpet of alarm, all right? They're blowing a trumpet of prosperity. They're blowing a trumpet of, you know, misinformation, okay? Because they're not alerting you to how serious the situation that is about to manifest upon the face of the earth. Therefore, they're not preparing you for the battle. They're not spiritually, mentally, or physically preparing you for the things to come. All right? And that's a terrible thing. That is a very, very terrible thing. And that shows you that they are stumbling blocks, man. All right? They were set up to misguide you. All right? They were set up, you know, to act as stumbling blocks so you would never come to the understanding of the truth of Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai. All right, you can't blow an uncertain sound, man. You got to, you know, sound the alarm, and you got to sound it the right way. You got to blow it the right way. You got to give the correct message. You can't omit information, okay, from the Holy Scriptures according to your liking. Okay, you got to deliver the truth as it's been given unto us through the Spirit and power of Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai. If you change anything, or you omit particular information because you might be uncomfortable with it, or because you ain't got the faith to believe in it, all right, then you're going to be destroyed. All right, along with your any members of your congregation that follow you, man. The scriptures say, if the blind lead the blind, both shall fall into a ditch, man. So that's what's going to be, you know, playing out in these last days. All right, there's also another one. Let me see if I can find it. Regarding the dumb dogs. Yeah, my keyboard's bugging out. Right. They ain't gonna come up. Right, let's see if it pops up. All right, beautiful. This is Isaiah 56 and verse 10. And it reads, his watchmen are blind. They are all ignorant. They are all dumb dogs. They cannot bark, sleeping, lying down, loving to slumber. All right. And that's you other Israelite camps out there, man. You know, beginning with your leaders. Okay. You are like dumb dogs that cannot bark, sleeping, lying down, loving to slumber. Okay. Because you're not barking and warning the people. Now, a dog, you know, if there's an intruder that comes into the house and you have a guard dog, that dog is supposed to alert you. That dog is supposed to bark. All right. That dog is supposed to sound an alarm and warn the inhabitants of the house of the danger that's imminent in the house. Okay. But you guys are not doing that. Okay, that's why the scriptures describe you as dumb dogs that cannot bark, sleeping and lying down, loving to slumber, because you're asleep. All right? And because you're asleep, you know, the return of Yahweh Shai is going to catch you unawares. All right? And let's get that right quick in, First Thessalonians chapter 5 from the top. This is First Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse 1, and it reads, but of the times and seasons, brethren, ye have no need that I write unto you, for yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. All right, so unto a lot of people out here, a lot of you Israelites, the day of the Lord is going to come as a thief in the night. You're not going to be expecting it. Okay, a lot of you are going to sell out, you know, to Esau, Edom's system. A lot of you are going to compromise because you weren't thoroughly warned about the dangers and the ramifications of taking the MOTB. All right, so a lot of you are gonna receive the judgment that's written of in Revelations 14. Okay, so it says, for when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them, as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. But ye brethren are not in darkness, and Lord willing, you know, that's us. All right, that are not in darkness and that are shrouded in the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai. Okay? So it says, but ye brethren are not in darkness, that day should overtake you as a thief. All right? Because we've been watching. The scriptures say, Yahweh Shai said, you know, to watch and pray. Okay? So we're like, you know, spiritual news journalists, man. We're constantly reading articles. We're constantly, you know, in the loop of the news. We're constantly in the spirit, you know, seeing what we can filter through the Holy Scriptures, man. Okay, the scriptures speak about being apt to teach. Okay, and that's the spirit that we're in, all right? Because we're looking for and hastening, you know, the coming of our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai, man. So that's what you're supposed to be eagerly doing. Okay, looking for signs of the Lord's coming, looking for signs of these last few prophecies coming to pass constantly. Okay, no one can deny that spirit is on Great Millstone and the members of Great Millstone. Okay, now it says, ye are all children of the light and children of the day. We are not in the night nor of darkness. We are not of the light of the night nor of darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober. Again, let us watch and be sober, man. All right, we're watching. All right, we are constantly watching. We're constantly watching, you know, for developments in prophecy, man. Okay, it says in 2 Ezra chapter 9, which is another one of my, you know, favorite scriptures, you know, measured out the time diligently in itself. All right, so we're commanded to measure the time diligently, man. All right, that's what we're commanded to do through the spirit and power of Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. It's to measure the time. And how do you measure the time? You measure the time with the Holy Scriptures. All right, you filter the events that are playing out upon the earth in real time through the Holy Scriptures of Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. Okay, now let's go back to this article. It says the European Parliament's started discussing the use of potential mandatory CHIP plants for workers. So they use that word mandatory. Okay, so this thing is going to be mandatory sooner or later, man. Okay, this thing is going to be mandatory. There's going to be a sequence of events that's going to play out upon the face of the earth in the very, very near future. All right, that's going to cause this technology, all right, to be made mandatory upon the face of the earth. And your only way you're going to be able to function in society, to function on Esau's grid, is if you have this mandatory CHIP in your body. All right, straight up, that's what's going to happen, man. So it says CHIP plants for workers, stating the legal, ethical, and health and security issues surrounding the potential use of the RFID plants. All right, and like I said, you know, there's particular words, I'm going to pronounce it differently, you know, to avoid the, you know, another sanction. It says, whilst digitized identity might have good or at least neutral intentions behind it, like desires for safety, welfare, health, efficiency, speed, and coordination, surveillance aim to limit and control our behavior or movements. And really, you know, that's what this technology is all about. It's about controlling, you know, your very essence. It's about controlling everything that you do. It's about controlling everything that you think. It's about knowing you inside and out, and knowing you better than you know yourself. That's what Esau's technology is all about. Okay, so, you know, although they point out, you know, always the benefits, and, you know, they point out, you know, how it's going to aid you and bring convenience into your life, the real sinister part about it, they never mention, all right, because they don't want you to know how dark it really gets. Okay, now there's another section I wanted to read here. It says, in 1997, the United States Patent and Trademark Office granted a patent for a personal tracking and recovery system. It involves the use of a tag and a reader. When scanned, the antenna within the tag picks up the radio wave from the scanner and sends a response back to the reader. The patented device was designed to be used as a safeguard against kidnapping, and to facilitate prompt medical dispatch in the event of a heart attack. And it's funny how, you know, a lot of people then, you know, suffering from this, what I've just highlighted right here. All right, from off of the back of taking that demonic serum, you know, that venom. All right, so just remember, you know, a lot of these things are, you know, they're orchestrated. You know, they're engineered, you know, to get a result that the wicked want. All right. Just a side note. Where was the other bit I wanted to get? All right. Let me get this part, and then, you know, Lord willing, we'll close out. It says arguments for use of the, you know, RF to the I to the D technology in humans. It says the supporters of the, you know, chips believe that such CHIPs will allow governments to locate fugitives, witnesses of crimes, and missing persons. All right, so you understand what that means. All right, what they're basically saying is that if everyone has the CHIP, if there's any crime that's carried out upon the earth, they can track you. If you was in that same area, all right, for example, let's say, okay, there's a particular town center, you know, there was a murder or a robbery, whatever the case was be. Now, they're going to track and see who was on the grid and who was in the radius of that crime or that situation, all right, that played out. And they can summon you to a particular government building, and they can question you saying, look, you was, 2 minutes from this incident, or you was, 4 meters, radius from this incident, what happened? All right. And you can't say, I don't know what happened, because it's already logged on the system on your, on your CHIP that you was in the area. So you must have seen something. So just off of the back of that, all right, they can actually charge you with, not wanting to take part in the investigation. You know, all kind of stuff can be bestowed upon you. And this is the kind of control that Esau Edom wants. All right. Now it says here, so it allows governments to locate fugitives, witness of crimes, and missing persons. The authorities in Indonesia's Jaya province even discussed using the RFI to the DCHIPs to monitor persons infected with HIV, which they'll put in HIV in the actual serum. All right, that's another thing that came out. They're actually putting, that plague inside the actual serum. It says the advantages for them are not only in monitoring. It says, I'm going to post this article in the description box for any of you brothers and sisters out there that want to read it. There's a lot of information in here. And to be honest, if you don't see, that the MOTB, the Revelations 13 and 16, is what we say is through the Spirit, then, the Yahabah Shem Yahushai is simply not dealing with you. Because at this point, the evidence is truly and astoundingly, overwhelming. All right? The evidence is overwhelming concerning, this the CHIP. All right? And this is a beautiful thing, man, because these prophecies are speaking, like it goes into in Habakkuk, the second chapter. All right, so we're in a very, very beautiful time right now, upon the earth, man. All right, so, let's get Ezekiel 28, and then we'll close out on this. This is Ezekiel 28 and verse 1, and it reads, "The word of the Lord came again unto me, saying, Son of man, say unto the prince of Tyrus," and modern day, in these last days, this can be applied unto Esau Edom. All right, he is, the prince of Tyrus. All right, this can be applied unto Esau Edom in these latter days. All right, so it says, "Thus saith the Lord power, because thine heart is lifted up," and these are, identifying marks of the wicked. All right, identifying marks of the Edomites that the Bible speak of, who is you so-called white people, beginning with, of course, your elites, the secret council of the wicked spoken of in Revelations chapter 64. Okay, the bankers, the elites that rule the world in secrecy. So it says, "Son of man, say unto the prince of Tyrus, thus saith the Lord power, because thine heart is lifted up, and thou hast said, I am a God, I sit in the seat of God in the midst of the seas, yet thou art a man." All right, and that's Esau Edom's whole, mind state. All right, he believes he is, the Most High. All right, and that's why, when you monitor his acts and the things that he proposes, he tries to change, what Yahweh Shem Yahushai has blessed and sanctified and made holy. And he tries to overturn that, and that's why the scriptures speak about the turning of things upside down. All right, because Esau literally goes out of his way. He goes, above and beyond to try and X out, the work and the righteousness of Yahweh Shem Yahushai. All right, that's what Esau does. So it says, "I am a God, I sit in the seat of God in the midst of the seas, yet thou art a man and not God, though thou set thine heart as the heart of God." And when you go into that Hebrew word for the word heart, it goes into lab, which means your mind. All right, so he set his mind, all right, as the mind of the Most High. And that's why he was to get inside you. That's why he wants to know everything about you. Okay, you have that film. It might be called Minority Report, if I'm not mistaken, where they basically sentence you for a crime that you haven't yet committed. All right, and that's, you know, that's similar things to what Esau wants to do. All right, by monitoring your body and monitoring your emotions, he wants to be able to say, look, yeah, we gonna, you know, do you for this, you know, grape, whatever the case may be, because, you know, it's in your intentions, it's in your mind, so we just gonna sentence you for it before the action is actually done. That's the kind of control that this man wants. All right, this ain't no joke. All right, when you're dealing with Esau Edom, you know, this is a sick and perverse and twisted things that he wants to bring into fruition. All right. And it says, and not God, though thou set thine heart as the heart of God. And you know what? I just remembered, as I was reading this article, it made me think of this film right here. I nearly forgot this. But this was sent out last year, around October, November time. You know, brothers were circulating this movie. And as you can see, you know, that's the name of the movie there. That's the trailer from 2021. Now, I watched the movie. It's you know, it's a good watch because they show you how the technology that they put in you, you know, the CHI to the P, they show you how, you know, it's going to be advanced to the point where it can speak to you, to the point where only you can hear what it's saying to you. It's going to be in your mind, you know, and they show you that in this film. You know, it was commanding her, giving her advice, you know, it was talking to her. She was having conversations with the robot in her mind because she had the CHIP, and that's the title of the film. And then there was a point where she wanted to cut herself off from it because she was basically, you know, it was just too much after a while. You know, it was messing with her. She wanted privacy. You know, she was basically invaded, and it was suggesting things to her that she didn't want to do, and it was basically controlling her life. And then she wanted to part ways, but it wouldn't let her part ways, you know, and it had the power to make her feel pain. So anytime she would rebel and get into that spirit of rebellion and trying to, you know, escape, it would just cause great pain to come upon her body. It's crazy. You know, and that's the kind of, you know, control that this devil wants, man. Okay, that's what he wants to do. That's what the world is leading to if Esau Edom was able to have his way, which he's not. All right, because Yehoshua Yahweh Shai is going to, you know, disappoint his devices, man. All right, and you know what, let's get that. And then we'll finish on that. Right. Should be in the book of Job. Right. Here it is. This is Job chapter 5 and verse 12. Let's get straight to the point. He disappointeth the devices of the crafty, so that their hands cannot perform their enterprise. All right, and that's exactly what Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai is going to do concerning you know, the wicked, concerning Esau Edom. He's going to disappoint their devices, all right? So this system, this New World Order system, will get to a point, and it will be, you know, flourishing and activated upon the earth, but it's not going to reach, you know, the point to where Esau Edom wants to have it, okay? Because the Lord is going to, again, disappoint the devices of the crafty. So he's going to get a taste of what it feels like to be in that position. But as soon as he gets, if you will, you know, familiar, you know, with that position, the Lord is going to take it away from him, all right? Because our Lord is going to return. Because remember, when you know, this system is mandatory and it's living, you know, in these last days, and people are on the grid, so on and so forth, we're going to be off the grid. Lord willing, we'll be all the elect. We're going to be off the grid because we're going to... the elect are not going to take the CHIP. So the Lord is going to be sustaining, you know, his men, women, and children that are of his election off the grid. Okay? The Lord is going to be, you know, looking after us, man. But we can't be in that position for too long, all right? That's why when these things start happening and being, you know, made mandatory upon the earth, you know that the Lord is going to speed things up dramatically, man, for the sake of his people. The scriptures say, you know, for the sake of the elect, the Lord is going to shorten the time, man, all right? That's in the book of Matthew, all right? So he disappointeth the devices of the crafty, so that their hands cannot perform their enterprise. He taketh the wise in their own craftiness, and the counsel of the forward is carried headlong. All right. So that's all I want to get into, you know, in this particular video. Check out this movie if you haven't seen it already. And you know, until next time, I'll say shalom.